Buenos días, señores y señores. Buenos días, Argentina y países de habla hispana. Estamos aquí en Coruña, España, en los playoffs de la Wftda 2018. Soy Tronchatoro. Un saludo para todos. Estoy acá con el hermoso de Bron.
And welcome back to the last day of international playoffs here in A Coruña. I am Brom, and this is the wonderful Tronchatoro. And you are about to see our amazing game of Helsinki taking on Dodsburg Crochos. And are we going to take a quick look at those rosters?
Tenemos para 2x4, número 03, Temis, número 14, Mandarina, número 24, Ladrillo, Tropical Mecánica con el número 26, Lula San, 265, 27, Espaoli, número 3, Carla, número 45, Maquilombera, 46, Estoti, número 609, Camola, número 7, Rayo, número 87, Flo, número 9, Loba, número 99, Chinaski, y la capitana con el número 8 es Papap.
And they will be playing in black, and Helsinki in green, 112 Fuchs, 156 Mia, 22 Malu, 24 Kujala, 257 Vega, 28 Nina Irves, 32 Vivi, 39 Mayo Rene, 604 Sarah Ekholm, 77 Oretku, 85 Latikanen, 88 Vapu Kanutila, 888 Lotta, and 90 Salah Kajalenin. Well, about to get underway, 10 seconds until the game begins.
Y todo está listo para empezar. El primer jam va a comenzar dentro poco. First jam, who's going to start in about 30 seconds.
And our wonderful officials crew are in place. Jam timer sticks to 5 seconds in the air, and this game has begun.
Tenemos llameando para la 2x4 Tropical Mecánica para Helsinki, la número 156, Mia.
And it is Mia that picks up lead for Helsinki, but not to the inside of the track, comes around turn one, so still tough to get through. Nice jump over the inside line to get through on that initial pass.
Y la primer penalty, first penalty of this game, es para el número 03 de la 2x4 Temis.
Yeah, Mia on that scoring pass sees the space to get through, and the first points on the board go to Helsinki in green.
Primer jam que termina con 5 puntos para Helsinki, en total 5 points in total for Helsinki in this first jam of the game.
Yeah, and pack advantage going into the second jam will sit firmly with Helsinki, as two Dodsburg Crochos players are sat in the quad skate shop penalty box.
And that's a problem that Dodsburg Crochos has yesterday, the penalty problem. They have a lot of penalties on the beginning of the game. Mm-hmm. Yesterday, the second game of the day for Dodsburg Crochos. So we will see if it's going to happen again or not.
And so jamming, we have Kujala, but it is Lulazan that picks up leads for Dodsburg Crochos.
Lead jammer para Lula Sam, el segundo jammer de este primer periodo, con una diferencia numérica a favor de Helsinki, solamente dos bloqueadoras de 2x4 en la pista.
So both jammers now on their scoring pass. Kujala manages to get through to pick up 4 points, while Lula Zan is stuck at that really tough Helsinki three wall at the back of the pack on turn three.
Kujala is the jammer for Helsinki, and she received the first points of this jam. The second point of this jam is the 5 points for Helsinki, and the jam is over with 9 points in total for Helsinki and 4 points for 2x4.
Community orientated like no other. Quad Shop is passionate about getting you what you want faster, cheaper, and friendlier. Check us out in store or online at quadrollerskateshop.com.
Todo está listo para el siguiente jam. Tenemos a Rayo, jugadora número 7 para la 2x4. La número 88, Barbu Kunutila para Helsinki.
And Kunutila has been a really formidable jammer throughout the international playoffs. Uses the and picks up a forearms penalty, just as a wonderful compliment left my mouth.
Y tenemos un power jam a favor de la 2x4, debido a que la jammer de Helsinki cometió un uso de brazos y es un lead jammer para Rayo. Todas las jugadoras están en la pista, every blocker on the track. Rayo que intenta pasar por segunda vez para anotar algunos puntos para su equipo. Rayo who's starting to try to pass for the second time and make some points for the 2x4. She did, lo hizo, anotó 5 puntos, 5 points for Rayo.
Yeah, the pack picking up quite some speed as Rayo came through on that first scoring pass, but the speed now taken off, second scoring pass. Canutila is now back on the track, but yet to get that initial pass. So Rayo looking to capitalize on that and try and draw out some points for Dos por Cuatro's.
Tenemos a la jammer del equipo de Helsinki que vuelve a la pista, Rayo intentando pasar.
Yeah, and Kunutila using the tactic of holding on to the star in her hand as she completes that initial pass. But Rasho choosing to call it there, picking up a great 10 points, and it takes the game to a tiebreak early on.
Y tenemos un total de 10 puntos y estamos empatados, 14 puntos para cada equipo. That's a tie score.
So don't forget throughout the game, get in touch with us using the handle at WFTDA Live on Twitter and the hashtag Talk2WFTDA. That's Talk2WFTDA. Choncho and I will be keeping an eye on social media throughout the game. We'll be reading out some of our favorite comments.
Tenemos Malu jamming for Helsinki, Lova jamming para la 2x4. The penalty box is clean. Everybody's on the track and everything is ready for the lead jammer. And in this case, lead jammers go for Helsinki Roller Derby.
Malu coming, just coming around the opposite side of the track to the pack, comes in on the scoring pass. Loba, yet to complete the initial, is fighting right on the other side on turn three.
Loba que logra pasar el pack por primera vez y se enfrenta nuevamente para anotar algunos puntos, pero este jam termina, the jam is over with 3 points for Helsinki and 0 points for the 2x4 in the last jam.
Absolutely. Not forgetting, obviously, Helsinki's route to this game saw them start on Friday against Detroit when they won 373 points to 160. And then they followed up with a game playing Rainy, where it was 146 to 156.
Tenemos a la 2x4 que jugó contra Sailor City Rollers, jugadoras también de Argentina. Ganaron 210 a 53 y les vamos a seguir dando el historial en unos minutos porque estamos de vuelta en el derby, back on derby. Tenemos Tropical Mecánica jamming for the 2x4 and for Helsinki is the number 156, who is Mia.
Mia, of course, has been another one of Helsinki's high rotation jammers, along with Malu. But Mia just struggling against that incredibly tough wall of black right on the pivot line. And look at the way they just take every inch away from her. And it is Dos por Cuatro's that pick up leads.
Lead jammer para Tropi, lead jammer para 2x4.
Coming in on the scoring pass, and Helsinki lose one of their blockers to the quad skate shop penalty box. Mia completes the initial pass, and just before coming in to score, Tropical Mecánica calls it off, picking up 3 points.
And we have the tied score again, and an official review as by Helsinki Roller Derby.
I'm going to keep a record of the ties because I think if we're going to see this nice and if we're going to see this throughout the game, nice to see how many times we see the score nice and even.
Yes, we only have 7 minutes of game, 6.5, and we already have 2 different lead change and tied score. So I recommend you to take a soft drink, enjoy, relax.
Put your feet up and enjoy the ride. We will bring you that official review as soon as we have it. Righteous Oxide will be the one that will bring that to us. There's some lovely feedback for the bilingual announcing
Twitter.
Skarmatic Huck says, I'm honestly living for this bilingual announcing. More of this, please.
Oh, thank you so much.
Tronch and I have worked together a few times now on bilingual calls and just...
Always in Spain, actually.
Ironically, it has been twice now in Spain. And we are accompanied by our producer, Blackstar Heroine, who is doing a wonderful job of keeping us updated throughout the game. Seven Wheels by Atom. Light, fast, responsive, everything you could look for in a wheel.
Helsinki are requesting a cut track call be issued on Dos Y Cuatro's jammer in the previous jam during the scenario at the front of the pack.
So that was Helsinki looking for a cut track penalty on Dos Y Cuatro's jammer.
That was a clear explanation. I love that.
I have to say, our crew heads have been amazing at articulating on the mic. Consummate professionals.
Yes, yes, we can see that they have a lot of experience and they're a very good official crew. And we only have, as I said, we only have 6 minutes and a half. As we can see some penalties, well, we have three penalties in total for Dos por Cuatro and only two penalties for Helsinki Roller Derby.
Nice and clean. We like that. And the officials crew, the wonderful referees stood in the middle at the moment deliberating over this official review's Righteous Oxide, Der Koenig, Jens Hotger, Martin McFly, Billy Hayes, Chaotic Neutral, Maria von Slapp, and Quads Law. And a really nice diverse split of teams as well. Dundee, Bear City, London, Mad Rolling, Brew City, Belfast. Nice diverse crew.
Wow. Thank you to all the officials, the off-skate and the on-skate officials.
So I can see that Righteous is just notifying the bench coaches of the outcome of the official review. So I presume that means we're probably about ready.
For the Spanish speaker, Helsinki solicitó un corte de pista para la jammer del equipo de la 2x4 y vamos a ver el resultado.
No cut call will be issued. Official review not retained.
Entonces, para la gente en Argentina, no hay corte de pista, no call stand. Helsinki pierde su revisión oficial. Helsinki lost the official review.
So, 5 seconds over. And we are back in play with Kajala and Lulazan jamming.
Lula están llameando para la 2x4, la número 24 de Helsinki, que es Kujala, llameando para Finlandia. Helsinki, el lead va para Lula Sam en el jam número 6 de este primer periodo. Lead jammer for Lula Sam.
Lula Sam comes in on that scoring pass nice and quickly. Meanwhile, Kujala is rushing in to come for a scoring pass. But 4 points picked up for Dos Y Cuatro's, and we see a lead change.
And another lead change, I think it's the third one that we see, or maybe the third one. Less than 10 minutes, and we already have three different lead changes.
There is something about, I think you carry kind of some kind of omen from Totoro, because this is now your third game mm-hmm. where it's been a matter of
yes.
points in it. And it's gone down to almost the last jam, isn't it?
I really think that the roller derby wants to kill me.
we definitely don't want that. But you were on the final call yesterday for
yes.
Crime City against
yes.
Angel, weren't you, as well?
So back on derby, we had the number 88, Barpo Kutnutila, jamming for Helsinki and for the 2x4 Rasho. But this time, the leads go for Kutnutila.
Yep, Kutnutila. Trying to hit that pack before Rasho gets out, but Rasho completes the initial pass. And Attila probably looking to hit it or quit it with the closeness of the game. But just 2 points picked up by Helsinki and shutting out Dos Y Cuatro's of adding any more to their score.
2 points para Helsinki en este último jam. 19 puntos para Helsinki, 21 para la 2x4. Only 2 points different, solamente 2 puntos de diferencia. Tenemos en la línea de Jammer llameando por primera vez para la 2x4 Toti, número 46. Y para el equipo de Helsinki, Malu.
Malu taking that outside line, gets recycled back quite quickly, jumps to the inside at an astonishing rate. Incredible amounts of juking at the back against Dos Y Cuatro's wall. Malu, however, is pushing up front, gets taken to the inside. Helsinki recycling her all the way back.
Tenemos a Nina Herbes reciclando a Toti al final del pack. En este momento Toti enfrentándose a dos bloqueadoras, tres bloqueadoras y cuatro bloqueadoras de Helsinki. Siempre en el back. Tenemos a la jugadora de Helsinki, que Malú que logra pasar lead jammer for Helsinki.
Dos Cuartos losing a blocker to the box for a cut track penalty.
Malú que intenta pasar anotando más puntos para el equipo de Helsinki. Vemos un puentecito del equipo de la 2x4 con dos jugadoras en la parte delantera del pack. Malú que logra pasar anotando 5 puntos para Helsinki.
Yeah, and you can see Vega up front there going pivot to pivot.
Nuevamente Malú intentando pasar la barrera de tres jugadoras del equipo de la 2x4 al mismo tiempo que tenemos a Toti todavía peleando por ese primer pase. Hubo un star pass, un pase de estrella. La nueva jammer es la número 03, Temis, para la 2x4.
Yeah, so a star pass to Temis. She gets through, completes the initial, and Helsinki call it off, adding another, a final 3 points to their score for that pass.
27 puntos para Helsinki, 21 para la 2x4, 27 against 21. As we can see on the repetition, oh my god.
That was Chenesky putting a wonderful hit there to try and take Helsinki's jammer to the outside on turn one. And we've also now seen completely evens as we go into jam 9, 4 leads apiece.
And on the jammer line right now for the jam number 9, we have Tropical Mecánica jamming for the 2x4, and it's going to be Mia jamming for Helsinki. And we have one blocker of each team on the penalty box. That means 3 different blockers trying to stop in the jammer for the first lap.
Yeah, well, Tropical Mecánica is pushing hard. Helsinki losing one of the 3 walled at the front. So we can see the request for offense to come in. Takes it down to 1 Helsinki blocker.
Nuevamente Chinaski intentando ayudar a Tropical Mecánica. Tropical Mecánica que se enfrenta solamente con 2 bloqueadoras y obtiene el lead jammer con aproximadamente 40 segundos, 40 seconds in this jam until we get the 2x4 lead jammer status.
And look at the way Tropical Mecánica comes in on the Helsinki blockers, bulldozes her way through to get the full 5 points.
Tropical Mecánica que pasa contra las 2 bloqueadoras del equipo de Helsinki anotando 5 puntos más. Volviendo a enfrentarse, logra pasar nuevamente otros 5 puntos más. And it's another lead change. Otra vez cambiamos el líder de este partido. En este momento la 2x4 domina con 31 puntos contra 27.
Yeah, and what we're seeing is 2 of Helsinki's blockers going to the box. A heavy penalty jam. Sorry, that was actually Mia that's gone to the penalty box. So we have a power jam in favor of Dos Cuartos.
Y este es el momento para la 2x4 porque Mia comete una penalty, es enviada a la penalty box y es un power jam para el equipo de la 2x4. Un corte de pista de Mia obliga a Tropical Mecánica a enfrentarse contra las 3 bloqueadoras de Helsinki intentando marcar más puntos para acentuar esta diferencia que pasó en este último jam.
Yeah, Mia picking up a cut track, now standing in the penalty box. Looking like she's going to return to the track with the helmet cover in her hand. But just as she's released from the box, the jam comes to an end and another 3 points added to the highest jam of the game, 18 points for Dos Cuartos.
En este último jam tuvimos 4 penalties en total para la 2x4 y 2 para Helsinki, de las cuales una fue la jammer y ocurrió un power jam a favor de la 2x4.
Yes, so 6 penalties picked up overall by both teams in that jam. 4 for Dos Cuartos and 2 for Helsinki.
En la línea de jammer tenemos a la número 24, Kujala, jammeando para el equipo de Helsinki y Lula-san jammeando para 2x4 y el lead va para Helsinki.
Yeah, so Helsinki respond to the lead of Dos Cuartos' last jam by going, this is our turn. Kujala, the one that's donning the star to take Helsinki to try and get the 6th lead change, I imagine, of the game.
Increíble pase de la número 45, Maki Lombera, nueva jammer, ex-pivot de la 2x4.
Some nice quick offense coming in from Helsinki's blockers, as Kujala just breaks through to add 4 points to their score and calls the jam off.
Estamos acercándonos a la mitad de este primer periodo. We are getting closer to the half, the first half of this first period. As we can see on the repetition, how the number 24, Kujala, get the lead jammer for Helsinki in the last jam.
The Kaya Topaz, this is no ordinary skate. Are you ready to experience ultimate comfort and performance at an extremely affordable price? The Kaya Topaz, it's time.
Jam number 11, who starts with the number 88, the jammer for Helsinki, who had the penalty, and she's leading to the penalty box, and it's a power jam for Roller Derby, 2x4 Roller Derby.
Yeah, and in the meantime, Russia is really pushing against that Helsinki wall, a full complement of blockers on the track. For the team in green, they look at the water falling around Rasho, but just a little too late. The last line of defense doesn't quite work. Rasho gets through to pick up lead.
Y teníamos un power jam para el equipo de la 2x4 con Rasho, que logra pasar con un hermoso pase en la línea interior, obteniendo el lead jammer, enfrentándose en este momento contra tres bloqueadoras del equipo de Helsinki.
Helsinki formed incredibly tight as Kanatila is now back on the track.
Tenemos a todas las bloqueadoras de la 2x4 en la pista. All the blockers for 2x4 are on the track. Three against the jammer of Helsinki and only one helping Rasho to pass. Rasho trying to pass against two different blockers of Helsinki. She get a no pass, no penalty. And now she's fighting against one of the blockers. She gets to pass and receive the first points. The second time that 2x4 gets points in this jam is 5 points jam, 5 points in the last lap for the 2x4 jammer.
So the pack picks up immense amounts of speed as it comes around one. The disorientation forces a call-off.
Tenemos un final de jam para la 2x4 con 9 puntos en total. No hubo puntos para Helsinki en el último jam. El puntaje 48 contra 31. 17 puntos de diferencia, 17 points different. At this time of the game, that doesn't really mean nothing.
I was going to say, if the first 10 minutes is anything to go by, we may well see some changes yet, as we see a timeout called by Helsinki. Helsinki choosing to take that timeout at the jam line. And Dosbeck Krochol is kindly stepping aside as well.
Tenemos un timeout, tiempo oficial, tiempo de equipo para el equipo de Helsinki, y los vemos en la pista, todo el equipo dentro de la pista, comunicándose en este minuto que se les otorga. Podemos ver algunas penalties. Tenemos a Chinaski, número 99 de la 2x4, con 4 penalties. A Temis, número 03, con 3 penalties. Y después tenemos a Maki Lombera y Papá con 1 penalty. In the other side?
Yeah, so just four at the only real person, four in the first kind of 16, 17 minutes of the game. Kanatsky with a couple of cuts and a couple of multiplayer blocks. So, but other than that, relatively clean across the board. Just a good opportunity to say, make sure you know the symptoms of a concussion and the return to play protocol for you and your teammates. And everything that you should be following for a safe game. Visit wftda.com/concussions for a wealth of resources and information on this silent injury.
And if you want to know the highest score on the jams, we have 2x4 jammer, the number 26, Tropical Mecánica, who get 18 points, and the number 22 for Helsinki, who is Malu, with 8 points as a highest score jam for both of these teams.
So that is relatively low scoring jams so far for Helsinki, who so far throughout the international playoffs, they've actually responded to some of the jams with some pretty high scores, and hopefully trying to do that. Just now is Malu, who picks up lead for Helsinki. Flo does not hang around though, completes the initial, and some speed is put on the pack by Dosbeck Krochol.
Tenemos a Malu, que es la lead jammer para el equipo de Helsinki, al mismo tiempo que la nueva jammer del equipo de la 2x4. Primera vez que llamea es Flo, la número, ya les digo, la número 87 para el equipo de la 2x4, que intentará marcar algunos puntos para su equipo al mismo tiempo que Malu intenta hacerlo para Helsinki.
So this is the first jam for Flo, and Flo does break through and pick up 4 points apiece for each team. So no point changes to the points differential. 35 points for Helsinki, plays 52 for Dosbeck Krochol.
4 puntos para cada uno de los equipos, como podemos ver en la repetición. Ambas llamas enfrentándose contra los muros. Tenemos a Malú utilizando a sus blockers, pasando a la número 8 y obteniendo lead jammer for Helsinki the last jam.
The S1 Lifer visor helmet, next level protection.
The next jammer is going to be Kujala for Helsinki at the same time that we have Tropical Mechanica jamming for the 2x4.
Yes, yeah, so Kujala pushing up front, but some space has been created for Tropical Mechanica. She breaks through the pack to pick up lead. Meanwhile, we're seeing a cut track on one of Dospekrocho's blockers.
Tenemos a Tropical Mechanica que pasa por la primera entre las dos jammers, pero tiene una penalty enviada a la penalty box. Power jam para Helsinki.
Yeah, so that power jam for Helsinki as Kujala comes in on the first scoring pass. The offense comes in at speed, allowing Kujala some space to break through on turn four to pick up a full five in the sky.
5 puntos para Helsinki en este power jam a su favor. 4 bloqueadoras de Helsinki against 3 different blockers of 2x4.
I just like the communication from Kujala, like waving. There's obviously some good hand signals that Helsinki have introduced.
You know that you have a good communication with your team when you don't have to talk about.
Yeah, just nice, just subtle. And it was a subtle hand gesture as well. It was like a small little,
hi,
I'm here.
I'm coming. Help me.
So just watch that moment that Kujala stretches out the Dospekrocho's pack. This was just after the speed was put in on turn three, gets through on turn four, and picked up a full 5 points.
So it was a 10-point jam for Helsinki in the last jam, and now we have the number 56 in this power star for, sorry, 156 for Helsinki, who is Mia in this power star, who just end, oh sorry, a power jam, who just end with gas, Tropical Mechanics back on the track, and Mia get the lead jammer status.
Yeah, Tropical Mechanica now fighting at the back. You can see that the pivot for Dospekrocho's Totti is looking, and oh, look at the seamlessness of that star pass. Totti was just looking to see if they were ready for the pass. Tropical Mechanica passes it, forces the call off by Mia. 4 points added for Helsinki. Just a 3-point game right now. So this was when Mia picked up lead.
Wow. Intento de jumping, de saltar el apex para la jugadora del equipo de Helsinki, que es recibida por una de las bloqueadoras de la 2x4. Lula Sam llameando contra Malú, 2x4 contra Helsinki, con menos de 10 minutos de juego, Malú siendo reciclada por Kamola.
Yeah, we've got Lula Zan. Looks like she was going to find a space through, but Helsinki just filled the gap while Malú is recycled back. We're seeing a forearms penalty going to Helsinki's 604. That's Tara Ekholm.
A differential of number four, Helsinki, but they get the lead jammer. Anyways, lead jammer para Helsinki, a pesar de la diferencia numérica de una jugadora en la penalty box.
Dospekrocho is having the lead for about the last 7 minutes. Malú looking to change that.
Solamente 3 puntos de diferencia, only 3 points different.
It's incredible.
And the
close
lead in the jammer for Helsinki, that can be another.
Another lead change already. Yes. Malú gets through on the scoring pass, so we're going to see that change take place now. Malú decides to call it off as the pack picks up speed.
And that was another lead change. Otra vez tenemos un cambio de lead. Es el quinto lead jammer o sexto. Vamos a confirmarlo ahora. Quinto o sexto lead jam de este periodo. Increíble.
So that is the fifth lead change that we've seen so far this game. But just 1 point between them. So,
yes.
And actually, Thomas Husby, on Twitter says, I woke up at 5:45 a.m. to watch this game and really glad I did. Absolutely, it is one hell of a game. Thank you for joining us. Hashtag talk to WFTDA.
Tenemos un lead jammer para Kujala, que llamea para Helsinki. Al otro lado tenemos a Rayo intentando pasar, obteniendo el primer pase. Kujala enfrentándose contra dos bloqueadoras, pasa, obtiene 5 puntos para Helsinki.
Yep, so Kujala coming in for the second scoring pass. Rasho has got out of the pack, now approaching for a scoring pass. Helsinki looking like they're quite happy to run this for a minute. Going to put some faith in fellow teammates as Russo approaches for a scoring pass, smashes around the outside of the turn.
Y este es el tercer lead jammer que Helsinki tiene seguidos consecutivos. Rayo intentando pasar. En este caso se enfrenta contra Nina Herves.
An incredibly tightly, densely populated pack on this third lead jam in a row for Helsinki.
Cuya la que se enfrenta contra tres bloqueadoras del equipo era 2x4 que la reciclan al final del pack. Al mismo tiempo que Rayo se cae dentro de la pista, no sale de los límites enfrentándose contra tres bloqueadoras del equipo de Helsinki.
We have a full complement of players on the track. A gap opens up for Kujala, but it is completely filled by Dosba Krochovs, and it actually allows another scoring pass to happen.
13 puntos en el último jam para Helsinki, 8 puntos para la 2x4, el puntaje 66 contra 60, solamente 6 puntos de diferencia entre estos dos equipos.
Build your dream skates on my bombs, lighter, stronger, faster.
Wow. Sexy.
So only 6 points sits between these two teams. We've seen 5 lead changes so far. We saw a tie twice in the first 10 minutes as well. So Mia jamming for Helsinki, Loba for Dosba Krochovs. And it is Helsinki's Mia that picks up lead.
Tenemos a Mia jamming para Helsinki, que obtiene el lead jammer al mismo tiempo que Loba sale del pack por la primera vez. Y Mia que decide cortar este jam. And confirmación de puntos, 1 punto para Helsinki en este último jam, 1 point for Helsinki in the last jam, 0 points for the 2x4.
Yep, a nice solitary point collected by Mia before being knocked up on turn one. And we're seeing a team timeout being called by Dosba Krochovs.
Team timeout para el equipo de la 2x4. ¿Qué partido? What a game, right? 7 points, the difference. Only 5 minutes in the first half.
It is you. It is every game that you have worked this weekend.
So you want me to leave?
No, I'd like you to stay because it's, I mean, and actually if you look at the penalty spread as well, it's relatively even. We've got, just got number 99, Helsinki, with 5 penalties at the moment. A couple of multiplayers, a couple of cuts and a forearms.
Tenemos una jugadora del equipo de la 2x4 con 5 penalties, Chinaski número 99. Primer periodo, arriesgado. Vamos a ver qué pasa en este partido.
Just to set the scene here for A Coruña, it's beautiful sunny day. It has got a little bit humid in the hall. But then we are right in at the top of this wonderful arena here in Spain. About 28 degrees Celsius.
I just returned from Argentina, and right there, it's winter time. So I was from, I don't know, 5, 6 degrees to 29, 30 degrees from yesterday. My body doesn't know how to react.
Yeah, I can imagine. And so the jam's back on. We've got Kanu Tila for Helsinki, Tropical Mecana back on track for Dosba Krochovs.
Tenemos a Tropical Mecánica llameando para el equipo de la 2x4. Barpu Kunutila llameando para Helsinki. Lead for the 2x4.
And incredibly well received by the crowd as well, that lead from Tropical Mecana, while Kanutila is being recycled and actually sent to the quad skate shop penalty box for a forearms call, and so a power jam sits for Tropical Mecana.
Tenemos a Barpu Kunutila que es enviada a la penalty box por un uso de brazos. Tenemos a Tropical Mecánica que pasa, obtiene 5 puntos en un power jam a favor de la 2x4 con solamente 2 blockers en la pista contra las 4 bloqueadoras de Helsinki. Tropi intentando pasar contra las bloqueadoras, 2 de ellas, 2 de Helsinki intentando evitar que ella pase. Tropi que pasa por la línea interior y anota otros 4 puntos para el equipo. Y otra vez, cambio de lead. Si no me equivoco, este es el sexto, 6 times that we have a lead change in this game.
Yeah, meanwhile, Kanu Tila has been released from the penalty box. She's currently got the star held in her hand while Mecana is up front and gets the third scoring pass. The initial is yet to be got by Helsinki. And we've seen a successful star pass by Kanu Tila to Vega, who completes the initial.
Tenemos un Star Pass, un pase de estrella para el equipo de Helsinki, pero el jam termina antes de que Vega pueda anotar algún punto. Son 15 puntos, 15 points, en el último jam para el equipo de Buenos Aires, Argentina. 0 puntos en el último jam para el equipo de Helsinki, Finlandia.
So, just under 4 minutes left. And this is the moment that we saw
Lead.
Oh, look at the fancy footwork there.
We can say that that's an upper chunk. It's more like a straight line jump.
Yeah.
Tenemos a Lula San jumping for the 2x4. And in the other size, 22, Malu, who jumps for the Helsinki team, who is wearing green and yellow t-shirts. And everybody's on the track.
It's nice to see an empty quad skate shot penalty box. Oh, we've spoken far too soon. Dosma Kratros loses one of their blockers to the penalty box, while Malou is pushing hard, 30 seconds with no lead so far.
Well, yesterday we saw a couple of jams, 2 minute jams with no lead jammer. And today, in the last game, we had one too.
And that's Lee picked up by Lulu Zan, but Malou is through less than 10 feet behind her. We're seeing an absolute jammer chase down. The blockers preparing themselves for the imminent arrival of both jammers, desperately clawing to get to the front. I think there's points going through on both sides. We've seen both jammers get through on scoring passes, 4 points apiece.
And that was time for the 2x4 to clean the penalty box, I suppose. And we had 4 points for each team. The differential gets the same, 8 point differential. As we can see on the repetition, Lula San getting some help from Kamola and passing the pack. 71 contra 79, 8 puntos de diferencia, 2 minutos que restan de este primer periodo.
Wftda playoffs are brought to you by the Radar Halo. Switch the Radar Halo today and see why Halo is the best-selling wheel in Derby.
Loba que llamea para el 2x4 y obtiene un lead jammer. Ha estado al mismo tiempo que Kujala llamea para Helsinki y logra pasar el pack por la primera vez. Y tenemos a Loba intentando pasar por la línea exterior contra las bloqueadoras del equipo de Helsinki. Decide cortarlo para que Kujala no anote puntos. Tenemos 3 puntos para el equipo de la 2x4, 0 puntos en el último jam para el equipo de Helsinki, equipo que no marca muchos puntos de hace 2 jam, creo. No, el último jam anotó 4 puntos.
So the replay, there's the moment that Dosma Kratros picked up lead. And so as we rapidly approach the second period and an official review being called by Dosma Kratros, but it's being used as a timeout.
Tenemos una official review, una revisión oficial pedida para la 2x4, que va a ser utilizada como tiempo del equipo. Eso quiere decir que no vamos a tener normalmente al referee explicándonos qué fue lo que se pidió, sino simplemente un tiempo para que el equipo pueda reposar. Podemos ver el bench del equipo de Helsinki hablando con el referee en pantalla. 1 minuto que resta de juego en este primer periodo.
So whether you're participating on the track, cheering on in the stands, or watching on WFTDA.tv, WFTDA tournaments provide everyone who loves roller derby with an opportunity to witness the most anticipated matchups of the year. Get your tickets for the 2018 International WFTDA Playoffs and Championships now at WFTDA.com/tickets.
Wow, I won one.
So we can see the jam is back on. Mia for Helsinki, Tropical McKenna for Dosma Kratros. One pack advantage is sitting with Helsinki.
Tenemos una de las bloqueadoras del equipo de 2x4 en la penalty box. El lead va para Helsinki.
And we've seen the helmet cover removed to get the initial pass.
Tenemos a Mia que pasa, obtiene algunos puntos para su equipo, 4 puntos. Viendo, intentando pasar, increíble pase. Anotra 5 puntos más para el equipo de Helsinki.
A really nice jump from Mia to get through the pack. Look at the speed that Mia just ran through. Dosvik Krotos didn't even know what was coming and get through to pick up 4 points. Both jammers now scoring, but Mia coming in on another scoring pass just as the period clock expires.
What a game, what a game. I'm totally having a heart attack this weekend.
It's an incredibly close game. 84 points is playing 90. And look at Mia's control.
Oh my God.
That was 3 hops.
I love that.
I would have collapsed on the first. So we've seen 6 lead changes at the moment. We've seen 2 tied scores. Overall lead so far, we've had 10 for Dosvik Krotos, 11 for Helsinki, just demonstrating exactly how difficult it is.
Algunos stats para este primer periodo. Tenemos 10 lead jammers estados para la 2x4, 11 para Helsinki. Eso está bastante reñido. Pero por otro lado, la 2x4 les otorgó a Helsinki 4 power jam, al tiempo que Helsinki solamente le otorgó 1. Y el jam con más puntaje es 18 puntos contra 13 que otorgó Helsinki.
Yep, and obviously we do have one on the Dosvik Krotos side that's looking a little bit on the danger zone as we go into the second period. We've got the highest point scoring jam, 18 for Dosvik Krotos, 13 for Helsinki, 4 power jams have sat for Dosvik Krotos as well. So, after all of that, after this incredibly close game, go and grab yourself a drink, enjoy the break, and we'll be back with you very shortly.
Bienvenidos a todos a esta segunda parte que va a comenzar en breve. Estoy acá con el hermoso y asombroso Brom, soy Tronchatoro. Les voy a hablar un poco de la historia de qué fue de estos equipos en este playoff de la Wftda. Tenemos a Helsinki que venció a Detroit el día de ayer, 373 a 160, y también perdió contra Rainy City, 146 a 115. Y del lado del equipo argentino, del lado del equipo de la 2x4, tenemos una victoria contra otro equipo argentino, contra la Sailor City, 210 a 53, y una pérdida contra Angel City, 218 a 125.
Yeah, and welcome back to the second half of Dosvik Krotos taking on Helsinki. I am Brom and joined by Tronchatoro, and it's currently sat incredibly close with Helsinki on 84 and 90 for Dosvik Krotos. Just looking at some of those jam stats for the first period, our highest jam ratio, it sits with Malou, number 22 for Helsinki, who has 75%, who's 3 for 4. And then we also have 60% for Mia, 156, 4 for 6. As well, and overall, actually, just we had a look at the tournament stats so far. Mia has a 71% lead ratio for the entire tournament, which is, you know, pretty impressive.
Yes. En español, para la gente que no ha entendido, tenemos la efectividad de la jammer. En el equipo de Helsinki tenemos a Malou, que tiene 75% de efectividad, y tenemos a Mia con 60%, al mismo tiempo de que Mia tiene un total de efectividad, 71% en el total del torneo. Y tenemos a la 2x4 con Tropical Mecánica y Lula San, que tiene 60% de efectividad. Y a Rayo, número 7, con un 50% de efectividad en este último partido.
So overall, we have 12 penalties for Helsinki, 17 for Dosvik Krotos. It's just Chizasiki. I'm just stumbling over all of my words at the moment. I apologize. But anyway, the game's about to begin, so we can come back to that later. Whatever that train of thought was, it disappeared into the darkness.
El primer jam que comienza con Lula Sam llameando para el equipo de la 2x4. Malou llameando para Helsinki. Una jugadora del team de la 2x4 está en la penalty box. 3 bloqueadoras de 2x4, 4 bloqueadoras de Helsinki.
So we've not moved very far, and Malou tries to find that opening space on the outside, but it's recycled back while Lulu Zan looks like she's about to find some space in the Helsinki wall. Is declared lead, but it has been knocked off between 1 and 2, so it is recycled all the way back, as is Malou as well.
Lula Zan, que obtiene el lead jammer, el estado de Lillehammer, pero es reciclada al final del pack, al mismo tiempo que la Jammer del equipo de Helsinki se quita el cubre casco. Lula Sam, que pasa, pero es su primer pase, así que no puntos todavía para la 2x4. No point yet for the 2x4.
And Malou gets through on the initial pass, thanks to taking the star off her helmet, as Lulu Zhang comes in on the first scoring pass. Pack picking up a little bit of traction around the outside of three, but calls it off and adds three more points to the Dosbekrotos score to take them to 93.
93 puntos para la 2x4, 84 para Helsinki. Tenemos 9 puntos de diferencia. Y el segundo periodo que acaba de comenzar, Tropical Mecánica en la línea de Jammer número 26 para el equipo de la 2x4. Y del lado de Helsinki tenemos a la jugadora 156, Mia.
Yeah, so Pack Advantage is sitting with Helsinki right now. Has given them that small advantage as lead has been declared for Mia.
Amazing star pass for the 2x4. The new Jammer is Maki Lombera.
And a very quick call-off for Mia, who sails through the pack to add 4 to the score.
And we have something that was kind of predictable. It's Chinaski number 99, who has 6 penalties in the first period. And now she gets the 7th penalty, so she fell out in this game. Chinaski, la número 99 del equipo de la 2x4, cometió un fall out y es expulsada de este partido.
And also, therefore, more than doubling her penalty total for the entire tournament as well. Picked up 6 so far to this point. So on the track, we have Gujala and Rasho.
Tenemos a Cuyala llamando para el equipo de Helsinki, Rasho llamando para la 2x4. Lillehammer para Helsinki, Lillehammer para Cuyala en el jam número 3 de este segundo periodo.
Yep, and Kujala coming in for the scoring pass on turn one. Rasho has removed the star cover and is now holding it firmly in hand, wedged between 28 and 90 for Helsinki, between Nina Irves and Connie Jalen.
Y tenemos a Cuyala, que anota 5 puntos para Helsinki. And we have a tie score, 93 for both of this team. The jam is over, as we will wait for the confirmation. 3 points for Helsinki. That's climbed the score, 96 for Helsinki, 93 for the 2x4. Is another lead change. The 7th time that we see a lead change in this game.
Yeah.
I think I want to have a heart attack.
Please don't. I could do with your wonderful continued bilingual coverage of this amazing game. Just take a breath for a moment to recoup our thoughts as Malou and Toti are on the track. Malou declared lead incredibly quickly. Takes a step to coming on that scoring pass.
Tenemos a Malou, que es bloqueada por la jugadora número 8, Papap, reciclada al final del pack. Al mismo tiempo que tenemos a la número 46, Toti, llameando para el equipo argentino.
Yeah, it was Papap that knocked off Malou and recycled her all the way back as well. And now the Dosbekrotos wall firmly reformed, full strength, taking every inch away from Malou. Toti is fighting hard. Helsinki lose one of their blockers to the quad skate shop penalty box for a forearms.
We see 2 different blockers of Helsinki going to the penalty box because of a forearm. Forearm.
Malou
because I was thinking in English.
Malou really struggling to get that first scoring pass. What realistically took her about 8 seconds to break through and pick up lead. Took nearly another 50 to get the first scoring pass. We've also seen a star pass for Dosbekrotos and Kamola. A great apex jump from Malou.
Star pass para el equipo argentino, Kamola la nueva jammer, y este jam que termina con 9 puntos para Helsinki, que pasa la barrera de los 100 puntos, 105 para Helsinki, 93 para el equipo de la 2x4, con 24 minutos y medio todavía de juego.
And it's just that little, that great apex jump for Malou. Wonderful. A big shout out to Rydell Skates, proud sponsor of the 2018 WFTDA Playoffs and Championships. Helsinki also broke the century in that last jam.
Yes, 105 against 93. Tropical Mecánica in the jam number 5 of the second period. Jamming and getting the lead jammer for the 2x4.
Wonderful matrix-like moves, just bending over the inside line to break through and pick up lead. Coming in down that scoring pass, Mia has removed the helmet cover from her head. It's currently held in hand at the back of the pack.
Tropical Mecánica peleando contra la jugadora Paoli, asistiéndola. Y Tropical que pasa y obtiene 5 puntos para el equipo de la 2x4.
Yeah, Maki Lombrera is the one that knocked off Mia there.
Nuevamente, Tropical que pasa y obteniendo 10 puntos en total, 2 puntos de diferencia, only 2 points different. Maybe we have the 8th lead change of this game. Maybe we will see at the end of this jam. Tropical Mecánica peleando contra las 4 bloqueadoras del equipo de Helsinki.
Yeah, brilliant offense coming in as well to help out Tropical Mecánica. Mia yet to get through on that initial pass as well. Came incredibly close. It's now taken her 1 minute 15 seconds. The wall formations from Dos Bocachos are just stopping her in her footsteps. Just over a quarter of the track completed. Starting to stretch out at the front now.
Podemos ver cómo Tropical Mecánica se encuentra peleando al mismo tiempo que Mia todavía no logró pasar la primera vez, y este jam termina al momento de que Mia logra pasar el jam por, el pack por la primera vez. 5 puntos más para las, la 2x4. Es un lead change, otro más. La octava vez que vemos un cambio de lead en términos de puntaje. 105 contra 108, 3 puntos de diferencia. Oh. Miren ese salto de Apex de Tropical Mecánica. Amazing Apex jam for Tropical Mecánica.
Hardcore says, trying to keep up with all the lead changes in the first half, and I mean now the second half as well. It's easier said than done. Keep them coming. Hashtag talk to WFTDA on Twitter. We've got Bobby Narco on the mic in the house, getting people really worked up for this close game.
And before the last game, 2x4 was a scoreless in 3 different jam, 3 consecutive jam. Prior to the 15-point jams that we saw in the last one, now we had a jam who just ends with 3 more points for the 2x4. 111, amazing number, I love this number, for the 2x4, and 105, because I'm 1,111 as a derby player number, so it's what I love, 111.
All the ones.
Yes.
So just some words.
Sorry, I'm a nerd.
Bench coach into Malou's ear. The pivot for Helsinki currently sat in the penalty box. So Helsinki have now been scoreless in the last 2 jams. Malou, with a full strength Dos Bocachos wall, is pushing with utmost strength. A forearms assist on one of Helsinki's blockers. Rachel takes a tumble, recovers quickly against 2 of Helsinki's blockers up front. And it looks like Malou might have found some space to break through. Out of play is called. Let's Malou through to pick up lead from Helsinki.
Tenemos a Malou, lead jammer para el equipo de Helsinki, al mismo tiempo que Rayo se encuentra peleando contra Nina Herves, jugadora del equipo de Helsinki Roller Derby. Increíble trabajo de ambas barreras, 3 jugadoras de cada equipo que retienen a Jammer casi a una velocidad de 0. Rayo con el cubrecasco en la mano.
Malou is really using every last bit of energy in the tank. I think maybe shouting back to hold in place. Good team communication. The offense now coming in. Pack starting to be stretched out at the front. Grasho at the back. Also pushing equally hard. I think we may have temporarily reached stalemate.
Tenemos a Rayo todavía peleando contra 3 bloqueadoras, al mismo tiempo que Malou se encuentra volviendo a la parte trasera del pack, siendo bloqueada por las diferentes jugadoras del equipo de la 2x4.
Oh.
Logra pasar Malou. So y tenemos un star pass para el equipo de la 2x4. Camola es la nueva jammer.
Yeah, amazing star pass and great duking from Malou to finally get through on that scoring pass. Calls it off. I'm just looking to the camera. So another 3 points added for Helsinki, and we've seen another lead change. The ninth lead change.
Oh my God. Are we going to survive?
I think we'll, maybe. So that was the moment that Malou picks up lead. The pack currently at the pivot line. Everyone comes back together.
Tenemos a Flo llamando para 2x4. Mía para Helsinki. Es un lead jammer para Helsinki, para Mía.
Lead jammer for Mía. A forearm's called on Dosvikorto's blocker. Look, Mia's last line of defense to get the lead. Mia bundles through, and it is also a power jam as a cut track penalty has been assessed on Flo. This is the type of time where Mia will be looking to bust out one of those massive jams and start to put some distance between them and 2x4.
Tenemos un power jam en contra de la 2x4 al mismo tiempo que Mia logra pasar y obteniendo otros 5 puntos más para el equipo de Helsinki.
And this is the first power jam we've had of this period.
Primer power jam en este periodo. Y en este caso es un power jam en contra de la 2x4. Mia, que decide terminar este jam con 10 puntos más 3. 13 puntos para el equipo de Helsinki, que hace que el puntaje sea 126 a 111. 16 puntos. And I love how 2x4 stay with the 111 because it's one of my favorite numbers.
But I don't think they're probably being appreciated yes. being frozen
now
out at the moment.
I feel a little bit of a hell, guilty, you know, because of, I said it was a good number.
So it is a power jam start for Helsinki with Flo still now stood in the quad skate shop penalty box. Ujala for Helsinki, quickly recycled. Flo has now returned to the track.
And we have Flo, who entered to the track at the same time that the pivot of the 2x4 goes to the penalty box, or no star pass for 2x4. Yesterday we saw a game of 2x4 with more than 10 star pass. So I was amazed that they were trying not to pass the star. And we had a lead jammer for Kujala, jamming for Helsinki Roller Derby.
Yeah, Kujala comes in on the scoring pass. Flo yet to get that initial.
Kujala, ¿qué pasa? Obtiene otros 5 puntos más. Y tenemos a Flo con la estrella en la mano. Y la pivot de la 2x4 que ingresa a la pista, reingresa de la penalty box.
Flo currently holding the helmet cover in her hand. And we've seen a seamless star pass as well to Mackie Lombera.
I told you so.
You saw it coming. You knew it was about to arrive. And that has forced the call off as well. Helsinki adding another 4 on that scoring pass to take them to 1-3-5 versus the static 1-1-1.
We can call that an Argentinian feeling. I was feeling that the star pass was coming in an Argentinian team. It was like, I know the smell. I smelled it before.
Powerdyne plates and skate products, cutting edge designs, cutting edge performance. Powerdyne, part of the Rydell family.
Tropical Mecánica, que llamea para la 2x4 y lo tiene Lead Jammer. Al mismo tiempo que del otro lado tenemos a Malou, número 22, llameando para Helsinki. 3 jams sin puntos para la 2x4.
Yeah, so this now brings an end to the 3 jams where Dodgeball have been scoreless. We see a couple of penalties being issued. Well, Helsinki's blocker was released from the box right at the end of that jam, and Dosbekrochos will be starting the next jam with 2 in the box.
Podemos ver en la repetición cómo Tropical utiliza a Paoli para pasar en línea interior, obteniendo un lead jam y anotando puntos después de 3 jams sin poder anotar. 4 puntos para la 2x4 en el último jam.
So we've seen a timeout called by Dosbekrochos.
Tenemos un tiempo de equipo pedido para la 2x4. Un minuto se le otorga a este equipo. 20 points different, 20 puntos de diferencia. A la mitad de este segundo periodo, 20 puntos a este momento del juego significa nada. Y como vemos en pantalla algunas penalties, tenemos a Sara Ekholm con 6 penalties para Helsinki, Chinaski que ya obtuvo el fallout y Maki Lombera que tiene 5 jugadoras, son 5 penalties, son las jugadoras que están en riesgo.
A very clean game across the board for Helsinki, but yeah, just Sara Ekholm at the moment sitting on 6. Obviously a very pivotal part of Helsinki's strategy. And just a great opportunity to say thank you to our non-skating officials, Pussy Panther Fast, Lil Bounce, Lins and Needles, Cluster Schmuck, Insane, Beth K Scenario, Riff Ref, Ragnarok from my hometown, Brain of Terror, Bleasel Bozo, Stydichris and Stagosaurus. Thank you to our wonderful officials.
Oh yeah, thank you so much. Without them, we don't have any high-quality derby as we can see right now. So I think we own something to these people.
So the 5 seconds is called. Like we said, pack advantage sits with Helsinki. Only 2 of Dosbekroto's blockers on the track. Mia and Luluzan. Mia blasts through the wall to pick up lead for Helsinki.
Mia contra Luluzan y Mia que obtiene el lead jammer para Helsinki al mismo tiempo que Luluzan se encuentra peleando contra 3 bloqueadoras del equipo verde y amarillo, equipo de Finlandia.
Incredible two wall there, and there goes some offense. But the offense has been called for a forearms.
Tenemos a Mia que intenta pasar nuevamente.
And a forearms penalty has been given to Mia, so we're going to see a power jam and the remaining 1:10 run out of this jam.
Tenemos a Mia que tiene un uso de brazos enviada a la penalty box. Esto es un power jam para el equipo de la 2x4. Power jam de la mano de Luluzan, que con la ayuda de sus compañeras logra pasar anotando 5 puntos en este juego con 20 puntos de diferencia. Hemos visto a Luluzan anotando 20 puntos ya. Queda un power jam todavía para Lula, intentando pasar contra las diferentes jugadoras. En este momento se encuentra presentándose con la número 28, Paoli, que intenta ayudarla en la línea interior.
And Vega returns to the track for Helsinki. Mia now standing in the box, but Helsinki now also seeing one more go off. Now on that second scoring pass, Dosbekroto's had another 10 points, takes them to 1-2-5.
5 puntos más para Lula que logró pasar, intentando pasar nuevamente, no pass, no penalty para Lula.
And the speed at which that all happened, Luluzan trying to call it off, realizing she's not leading, there's still 20 seconds left of the jam.
Luluzan que intenta cortar este jam, pero no puede hacerlo porque no es la lead jammer. Y se encuentra nuevamente peleando en este caso contra 2 bloqueadoras con la ayuda de Camola e un increíble pase. That was a spin move, a master spin move. And the jam is over with another 5 points for the 2x4. 15 puntos en total para el equipo de la 2x4. 11 puntos para el equipo de Helsinki. 146 a 130. Solamente 16 puntos de diferencia.
So there was, and then that was the offense from Vega that resulted in Vega picking up a forearms penalty. So 26 points picked up across the board in that jam. 15 for Dosbekroto's, 11 for Helsinki.
Tenemos a la jugadora número 9, Loba, llameando para la 2x4. Y del otro lado a Kujala, que llamea para Finlandia. Lead jammer para Helsinki, lead jammer para Kujala. Loba que se saca el cubre casco intentando hacer un pase de estrella. Lo logra hacer. Oh. Maki Lombera nuevamente. Jammer por un pase de estrella.
Yes, yeah, so Starbrush Lombera and immediately gets the initial pass. Kujala just goes, now I'm calling it off, and adds 4 points more to Helsinki to take them to 150. 7 wills by Atom, light, fast responses, everything you can look for in a will, and community orientated like no other. Quad Skate Shop is passionate about getting you what you want faster, cheaper and friendlier. Check them out in store or online, quadrollerskateshop.com.
Podemos ver la repetición como Kujala logró pasar su línea exterior, increíble pase, lead jammer para Helsinki en el último jam. Y ahora vamos a ver Tropical Mecánica número 26 jammeando para la 2x4. Y del otro lado tenemos a Malú y en este momento el lead va para la 2x4.
Brilliant. Tropical Mecánica picking up lead for Dosbekroto's as Malú is off to the penalty box for a cut track. We have another power jam for Dosbekroto's.
Y tenemos otro Power Jam a favor de la 2x4 con Tropical Mecánica, que logra pasar anotando 5 puntos más para el equipo de la 2x4 con una diferencia solamente de 15 puntos. Logra pasar nuevamente Tropical, 5 puntos más para el equipo de la 2x4. 10 puntos de diferencia, only 10 points different. Tropical Mecánica, who passed for the third time.
So we're now seeing, and look at that, another third scoring pass with Dos Cuatros.
Nuevamente Tropical Mecánica pasa anotando otros 5 puntos más, only 5 points different, solamente 5 puntos de diferencia. Tropical Mecánica intentando pasar nuevamente, al mismo tiempo que la Jammer de Helsinki vuelve a la pista después de la falta que se le fue cobrada.
And at the back of the pack, Malou is pushing incredibly hard. And we've seen a successful star pass, incredibly well-placed pivoting from Vega. And so Vega completes the initial for Helsinki. Pack picks up a little bit of pace on turn four. But Dos Becrochos call it there. 19 points makes it a one-point game.
And that was the highest score jam for the 2x4, 19 points, and that's amazing, only 1 point difference, solamente un punto de diferencia. Este fue el jam con más puntos para 2x4, 19 puntos en el último jam en este partido, un punto de diferencia, so, 149 against 150.
So we have a timeout called by Helsinki. Great time to take a look at some of your hashtag talk to WFTDA comments on Twitter. Bilingual announcing for this game, yes, 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 yes. Why is this not happening more? I need to brush up on my Spanish, says Attitude and Point. And you know what? So do I. And Tronchatoro and I have reached a comfortable place over the last year, yeah, whereby I don't know what she's saying, but we understand enough of each other that we can make this work.
You know what? I always want people who join Derby, people who speak Spanish, because I want someone else to speak Spanish. So please enjoy your Spanish, practice your Spanish, and come to announce with me.
And
please,
are you available for lessons as well? Are we going to sit down after this and teach me some Spanish?
Yeah, why not? I can do a tutorial on YouTube, like, hi, I'm Tronchatoro.
Bomb the Athena plates, lightweight aluminium, 20-degree plates. Come take a look. And Hazchem on Twitter says, turns on Helsinki versus Dos Becrochos. Oh, this game's on fire.
I think I didn't realize. I'm just sweating, you know.
Yeah. Oh, that's why we're so hot.
Yeah. Oh, now I understand. Everything has sense. We're back on Derby. Lula-san jamming for the 2x4. And we have Mia, who get the lead jammer for Helsinki. Lead jammer para Helsinki. La mano de Mia al mismo tiempo que Lula-san se encuentra peleando. Tenemos un Star Pass, un pase de estrella. Camola es la nueva jammer para el equipo de la 2x4. Mia, que decide cortar este jam.
Dos Becrochos have been making incredible use of the Star Pass throughout this game to force those short call-offs from Helsinki.
Tenemos 2 puntos en el último jam para Helsinki, 152 a 149.
6 passes.
6 pases de estrella para 2x4, but yesterday we saw 2x4 having more than 10
wow
star passes
great
in a
and
game.
And it's working for them. Their strategy is working.
Yes.
The S1 Life Advisor helmet, next level protection.
And we have the number 24, número 24, Cuyala, que llamea para Helsinki, pero el lead va para Loba, número 9, lead jammer para 2x4, con solamente 3 puntos de diferencia, only 3 points different.
And Kujala gets through, though, on the initial pass as Loba comes in for the scoring pass. One more, looks around to teammates. And what we've seen is a power jam for Kujala.
Esto es un power jam para el equipo de Helsinki. Por un alguna penalti.
Thank you.
Some penalty. Tenemos un power jam. We have a power jam for Helsinki team. It's Kujala who is jamming against 3 different blockers of the 2x4 team.
And look at some great footwork coming out of Kujala. Kujala temporarily thinking she may be lead, but
Cuyala que intenta cortar el jam, pero no es la lead jammer, por lo tanto, el jam va a continuar.
Loba returns to track, hits that Helsinki wall at the back. Helsinki well ready for her return, are not going anywhere, while neither jammer has yet to pick up any points for respective scores yet, with 37 seconds left on the jam clock.
Casi 3 cuartos de este jam. No veis puntos todavía. Cuyala, que cree haber pasado, duda un poco. Continúa su pase y sí había pasado, anotando 5 puntos más al mismo tiempo que Loba marca 4 puntos.
And the two jammers coming up side by side as they re-enter for their second scoring pass. Ujala just got one more, but Loba breaks through to pick up another 4 for the score, which takes it to tie break.
Tenemos un empate, tight score, 157 for each team. And we are waiting for some... Oh my God, 1 point for each team! Still a tie score! I'm going to die officially,
the third,
right now.
That is the third tied score this game.
Oh my God, 3 veces un empate en este partido, 158 para cada uno. Quedan solamente 6 minutos. We only have 6 minutes and 20 seconds. And sorry, and 13 seconds left in this second period.
And Malou and Tropical Mekana are going skate to skate for this one as the full 80 wheels hit the track. Everyone's back in play.
Malou contra Tropical Mecánica en el jam número 16 con un puntaje de empate. Todos los jugadores están en la pista. Lead para Helsinki. Lead jammer for Helsinki, lead jammer for Malou.
Yeah, Malou picks up lead. Tropical Mekana is being recycled back, has removed the helmet cover and is coming in now for to try and get that initial pass. A scoring pass for Malou, sees a lead change, which takes us to 10? Yeah, 10 lead changes.
Oh my God. And we have a star pass for the 2x4, pase ya para el equipo de la 2x4. Camola, la nueva jammer, al mismo tiempo que Malou marcó ya 5 puntos e intenta pasar nuevamente, logra hacerlo. Esperamos la confirmación del referee, este jam termina con 4 puntos más para el equipo de Helsinki, 9 en total y 2 puntos para la 2x4. 167 puntos para Helsinki, 160 para la 2x4. 7 points different, as we can see on the repetition how the amazing work Malou is doing on the outside line.
Yeah, incredible.
Wow. Chapeau.
So we'll take a moment to just gather your breath, everybody out there at WFTDA.tv. And we're going to see Mia and Lulu Zan. Pack advantage sits with Dosba Krotos. And it is Lulu Zan that, with a twist and a turn, gets around the outside of turn one to pick up lead.
Lula San, que logra pasar y es la lead jammer con solamente 7 puntos de diferencia, 4 minutos y medio que restan este segundo periodo en este partido de Helsinki contra la 2x4. Lula San peleando, ayudándose de una de sus compañeras, intentando pasar, anotando puntos para la 2x4. As we can see, Lula San being recycling in the back of the pack at the same time that we had a star pass for the Helsinki team, and the new jammer is Vega. Vega, who just passed. And that was the first pass for Vega. Lula San trying to get some points for the 2x4.
There's been a few times this tournament where we've seen Vega receive the star for Helsinki during passes, but Helsinki shut off of changing their score on that one as Dosba Krotos add another 5 points to their score to make it a 2-point game.
En el último ya, Lula San anotó 5 puntos, solamente 2 puntos de diferencia con 3 minutos y medio que nos quedan de este segundo periodo. En la línea de jammer tenemos a la jugadora número 9, Loba, contra la jugadora número 24 del equipo de Helsinki, Kujala.
So just over 3 minutes, Loba and Kujala are the ones fighting through. Loba picks up lead. They are just 2 points behind Helsinki right now. Both teams are going to be looking for clean gameplay as one of 2x4's blockers is released from the box. And we've seen a cut track penalty given.
Tenemos Loba, que es la jammer líder, y la jammer del equipo de Finlandia comete un corte de pista, sos un power jam para Loba, que acaba de cambiar nuevamente. 5 puntos más para el equipo de la 2x4. En el momento que dije la frase, hizo otros 5 puntos más, 10 puntos para la 2x4, 165 a 167, con 2 minutos y medio que quedan de este partido, Lova intentando pasar contra la jugadora número 85, Latikalainen, del equipo de Finlandia. Logra pasar nuevamente. Son 5 puntos más para la 2x4. 180-167.
Yeah, Helsinki's blockers could not return to the track quick enough from the penalty box, with Loba just sailing around the outside on turn one on the last scoring pass. Comes in now on the fourth scoring pass. Helsinki lose another blocker to the box. Going to need to look for cleaner gameplay to see this score differential get closer again. Loba working incredibly hard, still being slowed down. Kujala.
Wow.
Oh my God,
Pulled
I think
off.
I'm going to die. Whoa. Please. That was Lova. Lova, number 9 of Sailor City. Oh, Sailor City. Of 2x4, sorry.
So Helsinki
she did 20 points, Sham. That was the highest score, Sham, for the 2x4 in this game.
Yeah. So Helsinki are calling a team timeout. We're going to see the moment that Lova broke through to pick up lead. Incredible replay. Comes up against that last line of defense, breaks through, and it's called. New backpacks by Atom are available now. Carry everything you need in one place. And Kaya skates. It's time.
So we have a team timeout. Tenemos un tiempo para el equipo de Helsinki. Y podemos ver algunas de las penalties. Tenemos a la 2x4 con una jugadora con 5 penalties. Y tenemos a una jugadora del equipo de Helsinki con 6 penalties. Not a lot of risk. Only one player of the team of Helsinki with a risk number of penalties. 1 minute, 47 seconds to finish this game. 185 against 167. At the moment, 2x4 is winning, but we already had 11 lead change. So nothing, it's already set.
Three ties as well, tied scores. So the Helsinki timeout comes to an end. And Dosma Quatros, Tropic Omakana, picks up lead. And Malou is going off to the penalty box as well. So we see another power tram with 1 minute and 36 left on the period clock. Have they given it all away?
That can be the last sham. Este puede ser el último sham. Tenemos a Tropical Mecánica llameando en un power jam regalado del equipo de Helsinki, intentando pasar contra las tres bloqueadoras del equipo de Helsinki que restan en la pista. Tropical Mecánica que logra pasar y anota 5 puntos más para el equipo de la 2x4. 10 puntos ya en este partido, en este jam número 19 del segundo periodo para Tropical Mecánica.
So Tropical Mecánica comes in on the third scoring pass and they have put some distance between them and Helsinki now. Malou is released from the penalty box and we are seeing the two jammers side by side, but still 54 seconds left on the period clock. Just coming to under a minute left on the jam clock. The bench is sitting, keep this running. Let the clock try and work itself out as the double century mark comes. It's slapped by Tropical Mecánica.
Oh my God, now we can see all the blockers of Helsinki on the track, all the blockers of 2x4 on the track. The jammer trying to pass Tropical Mecánica, who's already done 20 points in this jam. That was the highest score for the 2x4. Tropical Mecánica ya hizo 20 puntos, ese fue el puntaje más alto de la 2x4 en este partido. Tropical Mecánica ya venció esa barrera, 205 puntos en este momento, más de 200 puntos para la 2x4. Pocos segundos que quedan. Oh my God, what a game.
So I think we are also about to witness the period clock come to an end. Just 13 seconds left on the jam.
Oh, in the last jam we have Tropical Mecánica que recibe una penalty box enviada a la penalty power jam for Helsinki.
But it's just a little too late as the jam comes to its natural conclusion. Just looking to the benches. So we do have an unofficial score at the moment, but it's looking like we're going to see a bracket upset as well, because the seeding's all off for this, because 2x4 came into this with seed 7, whereas Helsinki came in at seed 5. An incredible game.
Look at the repetition, how Tropical Mecánica... What?
I love that when you just summarize something with a noise, because that's all that can be due.
That is not a gravity movement. She is defining gravity.
And look at the celebration on Dos Macrochos' faces right now. They should be so proud of themselves. In just those last four jams, broke away from Helsinki, put some distance between it. Some, unfortunately, a few penalty troubles for Helsinki as well in those last three. Just created that perfect blend of circumstances that Dos Macrochos needed.
I'm waiting for this team to replay. Because that is a game that I really, really want to see.
Lightning Slim, by the way, says it should be noted that not only is Troncho calling the game in Spanish, she's transitioning flawlessly to English as well. And she speaks other languages. So Lightning Slim's a big fan from you. And that's on
Thank
Twitter.
Thank you so much.
And there's a lot of people posting GIFs of things exploding and just going like, oh my word, this whole international playoffs has just been phenomenal. Game after game after game of close calls.
People... Thank you so much to hear it to us. Sorry if we are shouting, but this game was so amazing. Thank you all for the support.
Yeah, and in a minute we are going to see the wonderful Very Cherry, who's currently stood in the sidelines, who is going to be talking to Dos Macrochos about just how they feel at the end of that game. We saw, just looking over at our wonderful producer, Black Star Heroine, 11 lead changes throughout the game, three tied jams. We saw two power jams in the second half for Helsinki, three for Dos Macrochos. 10 leads Helsinki, 9 for Dos Macrochos. I mean, it was just side by side the entire time. But Dos Macrochos making the most of those star passes throughout, 7 in total throughout the game.
Y este fue un partido realmente para recordar, tenemos 11 veces, 11 cambios de puntaje. Finalmente la victoria fue para 2x4, equipo de Argentina, equipo de Buenos Aires. El puntaje más alto fue de 23 y fue el último jam, así que les podemos asegurar que este partido se va a volver a jugar, estamos esperando que se vuelva a jugar. Les agradecemos a todo el mundo por escucharnos. Tengo la hermosa dicha de poder locutar con Bron. Yo me llamo Troncha Toro, originariamente de Argentina. Les mandamos sus saludos a todos. Helsinki, we love you.
So coming up next, we're going to see Angel take on Rainy City, and one of them is going to be going home with this wonderful bronze medal. So now it's time to hand over in just a second. We'd like to keep going. Look, I'll let you have another look. Have a close look at that.
I already took a picture with that.
It's a beautiful medal.
Yes.
It's absolutely wonderful.
Can I steal it?
And of course, let's not forget, the winner of that Rainy Angel game is guaranteed to go to champs. So Rainy and Angel are going to fight hard side by side for that to take place. One eye over on corner one of the track as Very Cherry lines up to talk to it looks like the entirety of Dos Macrochos. So let's hand over. I've been Brom.
I'm Troncha Toro.
And we'll see you soon.
Hello and welcome trackside. I am Very Cherry on WFTDA.tv. I am here with the fantastic Dos Por Cuatro. With most of them are here, but I am with Tropical Manica and...
Paoli.
Hello and welcome. So, quick easy question. How was it for you?
It was too hard for us, but yeah. And it was the revenge of the big O. So it was too much pressure, but it's so exciting.
Hello, I've just been joined by everybody.
Hi.
How did you find that one as the jammer for one of the last jams there?
Oh, very difficult, but with a lot of heart, really.
No one could deny that, that the teams, both of you from Buenos Aires, have come with so much love and heart and passion here, and it's fantastic to have you here in A Coruña for the WFTDA International Playoffs. One quick question, do you think it helped all the training that you guys did before the World Cup?
Yes, because we are Finland.
It was like really close,
so
we trained to turn around it.
I'm going to give a shout out to the bench coach because he's doing a fantastic job of translating. Hello. He didn't want to be on the camera though, so I'm going to let you carry on your celebrations because you definitely deserve them. Thank you for joining me here trackside. I've been Very Cherry with Dos Por Cuatro Roller Derby. See you soon.